Everyone, my name is Ajeet Singh Raina. I'm a Docker captain, and today I'm going to show you how to run Redis inside a Docker container. There are five quick steps which we are going to follow. First, we'll install Docker, then we'll create a Docker network, we'll run a Redis container, import user datasets, and then finally we are going to clean up database as well as containers. The first and the foremost thing which you need to do is ensure that you have a Docker installed on your local machine. So docker-v is the command which can help you find out whether the Docker is installed or not. So we are running a very latest version of Docker on our Docker desktop. The second step is we will create a Docker network. So this is important when you want to really tie up the Redis container to a specific network. So docker network create is a specific command, and here we are creating a bridge network by name Redis net. The third step is going to be running a Redis container. So to run a Redis container, we use docker run command, specify the port we want to run it. We want to specify -t to run it in the background, and then you specify a particular network which you have created. Now if you have already a Redis container running by the same name, you are going to encounter this error. The quick way to get rid of this is you just run docker system prune command and get it deleted. Now since we have used docker system prune command, it will basically go ahead and delete the network. So let's recreate it, and this time you will see that the Redis container is up and running. You can check it with by a command called Redis ps command, which shows all the running container in your system. Now the quick way to go ahead and connect to the Redis database is using a Redis CLI. I assume that you have already a Redis software which is installed on your Mac machine. You can log in into it, and then you can enter into the Redis server and run info keyspace command to see the keys. You can run set and get commands, since Redis is the key value store. Now we are going to import a user datasets of around 6,000 keys, and to make it simple, I have a GitHub repo which I have already created and hosted under Redis developer GitHub organization. So just go ahead, clone the repository. Since I have already done it, it says like it's already exist. Under Redis dataset directory, you have a folder called as user database, and under that there is a script which is primarily a sets of Redis commands. And you can see here, basically it is basically a key of details, like the user details, like the email addresses, name, first name, last name, IP addresses, as well as the gender. Now these are the sets of around 6,000 plus user database, and the quick way of importing it is using a Redis CLI command. So I'm going to show you how it works. So Redis CLI, you specify the host name, port, and then you use a redirect key provided with the file name ending with .redis to quickly go ahead and import those 6,000 entries. Now this is going to get, it is going to take some seconds, and then after that you will see that the whole data is being imported into the Redis database. You can also use the monitor command in a new terminal to see how this data is being inserted. So if you see here, it shows like it's close to 6,000 users which are created. Now if you really want to go ahead and run some sort of query around it, so you can go to redis.io command and see how those hashes specific commands can be used. So in this example, we are going to query a particular user with 3333 ID, and then we will query the username, the first name, the last name, right? So to do that, we are going to use the hmget command. So let me show you here. So we have hmget, you specify the user, the first name, last name, and the city, and it is going to show you. Now we saw that how we imported it and how we can run a specific query on top of it, right? The last step is the cleaning up. So we are going to clean up in terms of database as well as the containers. So flush db is a command And you can verify now the key space by running info key space where it shows the zero keys. In the same way, we want to clean up a container. So we run docker ps command to see the container ID and docker stop to specifically stop that particular container. So in this way, you learned how those the keys can be important. So these are the few for the references. These are the two of the links which you can go through and check it out. So I have pasted it in the description section also. Thank you so much.